There's the ritual that, you know, we don't touch the water unless we win. And that's just the top of the top. The run into the ocean is the most amazing feeling in the world. And I'm planning on doing that this year. Hi, my name is Monica Aldama, and today I'll be watching clips of some notorious Netflix teams and giving them all my coaching advice. Now we're watching a clip from Cobra Kai.
Go ahead! The student only speaks when spoken to, is that understood?
Yes. Yes, sir.
You'll always address me as sensei, is that understood?
I'm not that strict with the kids. I definitely believe in communicating.
All right, you ready to begin your training?
Yeah, sensei.
What the?
Oh, what?
Lesson one. Strike first. Never wait for the enemy to attack.
You could give me like a warning.
Quiet!
Oh my gosh, I would never do that. I definitely believe in self-confidence and, you know, the intimidation factor sometimes doesn't work, you know, with building up that confidence. So definitely a different style in karate than cheerleading, at least for me. Definitely karate could use some cheerleaders. I think everybody could use some mat talk. Okay, now we're gonna watch a clip from Beyond the Lights.
They're not a great team, and we're playing down. So you better figure out, and you better get your juice back in the second half, because the momentum, you let them have it back with 5 minutes to go, when we had it all.
I think the key to a good pep talk is to build confidence in every single athlete out there, because you just gotta make sure you're letting them know that you believe in them.
Hey, this is not what we should be doing right now. We should be coming together as one, not messing each other up.
Come on.
Don't let our tempers take us. Let's go. But it's games, you gotta act like we're losing. It's tied up. We get the ball first, we're gonna score. Let's go.
And I think this is so amazing that this teammate steps up and he gives them the encouragement that they need to go back out there and kick some butt out on that field. Now we're gonna watch a clip from Glow. You know, I love a beautiful uniform because to me, at the end of the day, it's still a performance. It's a whole bunch of athleticism and difficulty into this beautiful performance. I love a beautiful uniform. And I think the most powerful thing about a uniform is when you put it on, it makes you feel so good and confident that it gives you that little extra bit of energy. These girls are really throwing themselves down to the ground. So we try not to do that. We try not to do that in cheerleading. We actually have a whole conversation about how to melt down safely out of a pyramid when something goes wrong. We never want to throw ourselves to the ground. But hey, it adds a lot of dramatic effect and is very entertaining. But I'm sure they probably need a chiropractor. So up next, we have a clip from Big Mouth.
15 seconds left. Bridgeton down by one. Nick Birch, mayor of Whoville, dribbles the ball up the court.
Andrew, get in the paint! You got a huge body! Use it, for God's sake!
Dad, be quiet. You're not the coach.
This is the bleacher parent out there coaching their own child. Definitely something I've witnessed many, many times at my own kids' games. So thank God I coach at college and I don't have to deal with that.
I'm not an animal. I am a flesh and blood child with feelings, sir.
With feelings?
Andrew, get your head back in the game.
There's 10 seconds left in a game I couldn't care less about.
I'm so sorry. I waxed your lip, Andrew.
And suddenly I'm interested.
Why is she saying this in front of everyone?
Your father made me do it.
There's plenty of crazy parents that really think they're doing a good job out there. Next up, we have Last Chance U basketball.
Giving a ball. That's a bucket every time.
Hey!
Whoa.
That's not a travel.
That's a travel, bro.
Hey, good move, Joe.
Good move, Joe.
I want that same contact up there. That's how we calling it.
We don't have referees, but we have judges. So I can't imagine. I mean, they're in charge of our score. I would hate to get on their bad side by mouthing back to the judges.
Give it to them.
I saw Joe.
Oh my God.
What?
Bro,
what the?
Sit down. Sit down, man.
God, take me out of the game. I can't do it. Take me out.
Sit down.
You have to know as a teammate, you know, how to keep your composure and when you can let those feelings out. And on the court, it's not the time to do it. You have to be there for your team. They need you.
Take me out, bro. Take me out, coach. I can't do it.
When you're doing something you're so passionate about, it's so easy to let those emotions just bubble up. And so it's understandable, but like I said, as an athlete, that's part of your job is to control that. You are not a team player if you're allowing your emotions to take over and cause you to become a distraction. So that's just something and each individual needs to work on to, you know, be a better teammate, be a better player, and to, you know, add value to the team. And this clip is from The Last Dance.
I had never met a coach who was that different and genuine when it came to bringing the group together. He had this real interest in Native American history, and he would weave that into our own culture.
I love that he is, you know, putting himself out there with his team and being a part of it. I think any good leader leads by example. That's how you earn respect. And without respect, you can't lead anyone or any team.
I mean, he brought in Zen Buddhism and Native American Indian philosophies. Everything was about being focused, playing as one.
He's out there on the floor, you know, leading his team, being a part of his team, and being the example. That's really, really honorable. The next clip is from Hoops.
Yes, 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 yes!
Holy fuck! It's boiling hot! What the fuck, you idiots?
Well, we couldn't find the Gatorade. Sorry, we panicked and grabbed the hot tea.
Why the fuck do we have hot tea in the fucking gym, you dopes? Holy shit, that is burning my ass!
Well, obviously, if we win, there's a ring ceremony, and that's very special. We don't get to do that, though, unless we win. So, once again, we got to get to work. So, I got to get back to Texas. Thanks for watching these clips with me. Make sure you check out the new season of Cheer streaming on Netflix now.